This is Ottawa's home for breaking news 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. News Talk 580 CFRA. Here is Rob Snow.
It's a case, I think, as you can imagine, that municipalities should be paying attention to all across the country. A woman was seriously hurt in a car accident 15 years ago. Her car was hit by a school bus. This happened in Sudbury. And the reason the crash happened, according to a judgment handed down in court this week, is because the municipality of Sudbury did not properly clear the road during some nasty winter weather. The judge, in fact, said the conditions of the road were treacherous, and the judge ordered the municipality to pay the injured woman $12 million in damages. Roger Oatley joins me now. He was not involved in this particular case, but he has been involved in cases like this in the past. He is with the law firm Oatley Vigmond, personal injury lawyers, and he joins me now from Barrie. Nice to talk to you, sir.
Thanks for the opportunity, Rob.
And in fact, you've been involved in the very first type of these sorts of cases in Ontario. Is that right?
Yes, you're right. Been involved in quite a number of major cases like this one against municipalities, where municipalities or any road authority has failed to keep its roadway safe for the reasonable driver to use under normal conditions. Yeah.
So, Mr. Oatley, you have a woman. She is seriously hurt. It's winter. The conditions are slippery. How do you go about making a claim like that?
Well, it's important to understand, Rob, that although it sounds like this poor woman has won the lottery, that's far from what happens in these cases. First of all, in Canada, for the most serious injury there is, can recover in our system for pain and suffering and loss of enjoyment of life is about $350,000. So when you see a judgment this huge, you know right away that it's compensation for all of the economic losses that she will suffer the rest of her life. Typically, a future loss of income for a middle income wage earner is in the $1 million to $1.5 million dollars. So the vast, vast majority of judgments like this are for future care costs. And the biggest one is tendon care costs for people who are profoundly injured, and because of their safety and their physical and emotional and cognitive impairments, they need to be looked after 24 hours a day. And that certainly was the case here. The grounds of suing in these cases differ from case to case, and they are very, very tough cases to win. This woman was lucky. She had Jerome Morse, who's a friend of mine and a damn good lawyer. Not a lot of lawyers can win these cases, because you have to prove that the road authority knew or should have known about an unusually dangerous condition that made it unsafe for the reasonable driver to use the road. And it was the unsafe quality of the road, whether it was the speed being too high or the lack of signage or whether it was a failure to meet the standards with respect to the removal of ice and snow that actually caused or contributed to the accident. And it's a very, very high burden to make that out in a courtroom.
And how do, you know, I say municipalities, but as you have said, it's not just municipalities. It could be provincial governments or any other sort of authority, I suppose, that's in charge of a roadway. How do they usually try to defend themselves in cases like this?
Well, the typical defense involves experts in road maintenance and highway design, engineering experts, all of whom testify typically that there was nothing particularly unusual about this road or the maintenance that was being applied to the road was more than adequate and reasonable, or the design was in conformity with the provincial standards. Those are the typical defenses, and more often than not, they prevail. So cases like this are not for the faint of heart, and typically when there is a judgment, it's a big one, because it's pretty tough to justify taking on a powerful road authority if the injuries are minor.
As they say, you can't fight City Hall, and this would be one of the cases where you can fight City Hall, but it's going to be a long, expensive fight.
It's always a long, very expensive fight. The last one of these cases I had, there were two lovely young quadriplegic gals as a result of a faulty design in a road.
Yes, I remember that one.
Yeah, it took years and years and years, and all of these cases don't end at the trial. They're virtually always appealed, so there's another year or two tacked on while the case makes its way to the Court of Appeal. And to take on a case like this, you have to have brave clients who trust a very brave lawyer who is prepared to risk hundreds of thousands of dollars in disbursement costs and very often well over $1 million in time. We read about these victories, and the reaction very often is, boy, that woman just won the lottery, but I can tell you that's a brave woman who needs every dime. And she had the good fortune to find a lawyer who was brave enough to take it on.
Well, I thank you for your time, Mr. Oatley, today.
You're most welcome, yep, Rob.
Thanks again. That's Roger Oatley from Oatley Vigmond Personal Injury Lawyers. He joined us today from Barrie, Ontario. Coming up to 3:45 now, News Talk.